My name is Yasir. I'm a PhD candidate in the Department of Pharmacology and Nutritional Sciences at the University of Kentucky, and I have been here since 2012. The research in Dr. Lisa Cassis' lab mainly focusing on the sex differences in obesity-induced hypertensions and abdominal aortic aneurysms, and the novelty of our works and the discovery of these genes that may identify a sex-specific therapeutic to treat some cardiovascular diseases made us successful to renew our fund from the National Institute of Health. Cardiovascular diseases are the leading cause of death in the world, and significant sex differences exist in the developments of several cardiovascular diseases, including hypertension, abdominal aortic aneurysm, and atherosclerosis. And most of the investigators that are studying the sex differences are mainly focusing on the sex hormones. However, the genes that are on the sex chromosomes represent another fundamental difference between males and females, but no one has looked at it in relation to the vascular diseases, because the males are always born with XY sex chromosome complement, while the females are always born with an XX. Abdominal aortic aneurysm, it's a permanent dilation in the abdominal regions of the aorta. The aorta is the largest artery in the body, and it is the biggest supplier of blood. This disease is affecting more than 1.1 million people in the United States that are aged between 50 and 84. And there is an 85% chance of death if get ruptured. And the male sex is considered the strongest non-modifiable risk factor for this disease. And that's a big sex difference. That's why we are trying to understand why the males are more susceptible and why the females are protected from this disease. In this study, we tried to answer the question, what will happen if we will put the male sex chromosome complement, which is the XY, in a female mouse in relation to AAA? So our hypothesis in this study is that the presence of an XY sex chromosome complement in female mouse will augment the development and severity of AAA. And in this study, we have used a novel mouse model that enables us to produce an XX or XY females, and both of them, they have ovaries. And then we remove their sex organs in order to remove the effects of their sex hormones. And in this way, we'll be able to study the pure sex chromosome effects. First, in the initial studies, we tried to define the differences in the gene expressions in the abdominal aortas from XX versus XY females. And we found that genes that are involved in the inflammatory pathways are highly expressed in abdominal aortas from XY females. And then when we infuse the XY females with angiotensin II in order to induce the AAA formations, we found that AAA incidence and the rupture were doubled. So in order to mimic the male environment, we administered testosterone to the XY females and we infused them with angiotensin II. We found that over 70% of XY females were dying due to rupture. And these effects were associated with an increase in the oxidative stress and matrix metalloproteinase activities in the aorta from XY females. The results from this studies indicate that genes on the sex chromosome complement regulate the aortic vascular biology. And the most importantly, it has therapeutic implications for the use of sex hormones in aging populations, in transgender individuals, and potentially may identify a sex-specific therapeutic that may be used to treat common cardiovascular diseases. And the most importantly, these studies advanced the basic knowledge of the sex chromosome effects on vasculature. We have identified two gene targets that we are going to test the efficacy of either blocking or stimulating them against the formations and the progression of AAA. I was very excited to get my paper published in this journal because this journal has a high impact factors and it is very respectful in the scientific community. And this journal has only an 8% of acceptance rate with a bias toward the clinical studies. So the fact that my paper get accepted in this journal, that means that there is a high quality of work and a relevance to the human disease.